Hey guys, it's Prospector Jess again, ready to go live. We got to talk about how storm cells affect gold. Today was kind of an interesting day here near where I live here in Southern California. We've been getting a lot of these storms coming through. Let me show you a little bit of what's going on. So today, I went to pick up my daughter, and it was dry as a bone. But by the time I got back, there was all that water and all those storm clouds rippling through this whole area of Southern California. It's dropping snow down to 2,000 feet right now, which of course means moving gold. But more importantly was that as I was looking at this area right here where it's pooled all the water, I began to see a pattern. And that is, I was down about a mile south of this, that-a-way. And when I was down a mile south, I saw sprinkles, no water. When I came back up here, it was flooded. The roads were all flooded out, meaning, and there was thunder and lightning and snow over in the hills over about there, okay? That's Newberry Park where the fires were earlier this year. So basically what we had was a massive storm cell move through here, a whole series of them. They're going to remain here for the weekend and drop snow at about 2,000 feet. But what's interesting is it wasn't supposed to rain today, but it dumped this kind of water. Now, what does that water do? Well, let's take a look. I mean, there was no water here. This was dry this morning. It's all flooded out. These farm fields are saturated. So what's going on is, as this thing comes in, it moves these huge cells. Some of them are supercells, the kind that generate tornadoes and the like, and they come through and drop inches of rain an hour. Now what happens when you get rainfall like that is something special. I'm going to go cover that tonight at 6 o'clock, so join me because I can't get my blackboard to work here in the field. But the idea is, as these massive storm cells start moving through, they start dropping water so rapidly that something interesting takes place with gold. You can guess what it is. Come and visit me at 6 o'clock and we'll talk about it more. Good to see you guys. Nice to see you, Bob and Lan. We'll catch you at 6. That's Utah and North Carolina. Did you check out the North Carolina post that I did? I just put it up on YouTube too today, so everybody can go check it out over there. All these videos are showing up there as well. Hey, David, good to see you. So, I hope that's an interesting post for you. No, I'm not going to talk about panning for gold, although we probably could. You know, I could go over here and get my trusty dusty pan out and pan this dirt. As you can see, there's lots of black sands, but it's asphalt. Although I probably should pan some of this just to see what's in it. You never know. Although, based on the USGS, this area isn't really known for gold, partly because it's alluvial and it's miles deep. So most of the gold has been washed out to sea, and what you find is fine gold along the Ventura River and the beaches coming south of there. But that's really it for today. I wanted to just touch bases with you and talk about these storm cells and kind of what they can do to distribute gold. Hey, Ryan, good to see you. And Jay? Got South Carolina, North Carolina, everybody showing up. This is good. And Mike, good to see you. Yeah, I love people who go for the gold too. It's really important that we support one another. There's some stuff coming down. Hopefully we'll get dredging opened up again. But even if we don't, we'll find some way around it. You know, there's always a solution. If you're an engineer, you always look for solutions. That's what I do for a living. So we'll just hang in there and keep going. Go for the gold and find more of it. So this is Prospector Jess, over and out for right now. Just thought I'd post this quick post and show you a little bit of what's going through my mind this afternoon. And stay dry and get that gold. Oh, and I don't know whether any of you have noticed, but there's some fantastic shots of this flooding in Palm Springs. Look that up on YouTube. As well as some really cool ones that are starting to show up out of the East Fork of the San Gabriel River. A bunch of the prospectors groups are now posting those, and it's pretty cool. There's some real water movement. Haven't seen it in a decade or more. So this is gonna change the gold picture quite a bit. So join me tonight, 6 o'clock. same place as we are right now here on Facebook, and then I'll be reposting onto YouTube on Prospector Jess channel. Oh, and subscribe to me over there. Both like the page here and subscribe to me over there so that you get notified when videos go up and when new information comes available. Good to see you. Good prospecting. Prospector Jess, over and out. Electric dredge is a good idea. Yep. Catch you later, guys.